Yeah. So, how's it going? Yes? No answer for this? Good. So, yeah. Great. So, let's see a basic form here. Okay, we'll put all the possible attributes we can. Okay, and we'll see. We're not submitting the form anytime. Okay, we're not going to submit anything there. This is just a basic design class. Okay, even if you try to submit a form, okay, you can't even understand. If you're a PHP developer or if you know what really a form does previously, yeah, you'll be understanding what it does exactly. But for the first timers, okay, when you're doing a form, you won't understand even if you submit a form. Okay, so great. So I'm going to share my screen here. As I told before that, you know, if you have any questions, keep that with you. If you can post it, post it. If not, yeah, just wait for the, you know, screen share to be stopped. Then I'll give definitely time for the questions and I'll be answering them. Okay, great. So here it is. Let's start. Every time I start the programming with the doc type, okay, doc type HTML, this means that, you know, this particular HTML file will be using HTML file will be using HTML5 standards. Okay, that's what doc type HTML says. Then there is a HTML tag. So every HTML tag has two children tags, head and body. So head is where you know, the settings will be set, like the styles or the scripts or the title. So here goes our title. So the title is Tutor's Live Super 10 HTML Forms. I'm gonna save this. So here I'll say forms or Super 10 forms, because we already have a Super 10 forms. Oh. I named it wrong. I named it as text file, okay? I should not do it. It's a .html file. So now it's a HTML file. I'll close this. Yes. Alright. So here, I'll use a heading, okay, just for the sake of it. Okay, I'll say this is an example to forms. Okay? Now here, form tag will start with the form, and we see we won't apply any attributes. We just, you know, just do something here. Let's see. Input type equal to, okay, type equal to, the first type attribute is text and self closing. We're not doing anything over there. We're just saying type equal to text. So then we have seen input type equal to, okay, password. Again, I'm not writing anything except the type, okay. Input type equal to radio, okay. Input type equal to checkbox. So these are the types we have seen, checkbox. And input type equal to button. Input type equal to submit. Input type equal to reset. Input type equal to file. Input type equal to hidden. So these are the basic input types. Okay, I just saved it. Then after the form here, okay, I'll be writing a strong here. Okay, strong. Okay, this is the basic skeleton, I say, because there is nothing in there. Skeleton of forms. So save it. Okay, I hope I'm clear. There are no problems. So if I'm clear, just say yes. If you could not type in anything or do something, okay, just leave it. I hope now I can understand it. Yeah, am I clear here? I've typed a basic skeleton of it. Just a basic skeleton of it. So let's see what we have got there. So this is our form. I click on Super 10. Now you see. Okay. So the first is input type equal to text I have given. This is password, radio, checkbox, and what is this? This is type equal to button. Okay. This is type equal to button. This is submit. This is reset. When I click reset, you see it has been resetted. Then I choose file. It's a type, and there is no input type hidden. It's not visible at all. Okay. So now you have understood fairly what exactly every input type does, right? And now you see this is a strong element. Now you guys tell me what kind of tag is the question here. I hope I'm clear on that. You guys have seen the thing. Now you guys tell me form tag. Okay, form tag, block or inline, and input tag, the same, block or inline. So what is your answer here? This is a question. You have to be specific. What is block, input tag, or form tag? So type in the answer. The first answer should be form tag, and the second answer should be input tag. So form is block, input is inline. Any other answer here? Form tag is block, okay, input is, and I hope Anil is following this. Maybe he could not type, but he still has an answer for it. So fine, that's a fantastic answer. Right, input is inline. Great. So now let's start filling up information. Okay, let's do something to that forms so that they look beautiful. Right. So I hope my screen is visible now. So here. Okay. The next attribute, name. Forget about name. I'm not giving any name here. Name is used only when you process the form. Okay. So we talk about name and ID in JavaScript. Forget or not, but remember, do remember. So I'll just leave them blank. Okay. So the next is placeholder equal to. This is text. Type text. Okay. So here. Name equal to blank, ID equal to blank, placeholder equal to, this is type equal to password. Okay, so radio boxes are a little different. Placeholder does not work on them, but they have different attributes over here, but that is nothing but checked. Okay, this is a standalone attribute. It does not have a value. It still has a value, but the value is checked itself. Again, the checkbox, I'll say name equal to, ID equal to, I can again call this as checked. Oh, I have to give a space here, it seems. Okay. Alright, then the button here. For the button again, name equal to, ID equal to, and this time it's a value. Okay, this time this is a value. This is type equal to button. Okay, again here, name equal to, ID equal to, value equal to, again here, there is no placeholder here, just observe this. Okay, this is type equal to, oops, submit. Okay, again coming here, name equal to blank. We're not giving any name here, okay, since we don't consider the name here, it's not important. And again value equal to, this is type equal to reset. And again this does not have anything, this just has a name and ID. Okay, so no need of worrying about it. Again here name equal to and ID equal to, so hidden, what does hidden really do? So let me just type a value here, this is type equal to hidden. Okay, so yes, input is inline, form is tag. Okay, fine. So let's see, let's go back to the programming here, the browser here, and refresh this. See now the placeholders. What are the placeholders? Placeholders are informational text. Okay, now I have given to the radio buttons checked and checked, so that's the reason they are checked defaultly. Right, but still there is no information about these buttons, right? The radio and checkbox, they does not provide any information standalone. They do not have any information. Okay, and this is type equal to button, that's a value, right? We used a value. So now you guys can understand what is a value and what is a placeholder. Placeholder is informational text for, you know, the boxes wherein I have to type in with keyboard. Okay, value is to those types which have clickable things. Okay, button is clickable, submit is clickable, reset is clickable, choose file is clickable, but still choose file, I don't know, the value does not take up over there. And hidden is not visible at all. So how do I see the hidden? When I click on page source, now I can see the hidden. You see that? You can see, but hidden is not visible to the user. It's hidden, that's why its type is hidden. Right? So let's do one thing, one more thing here. I'm gonna use a BR here so that everything looks fine and fair. So BR. So I'm gonna ask you guys a question. Okay, be prepared for the question here. So no need for BR for that. So I'm gonna refresh. Now everything is properly aligned vertically. Now let's do one more thing. Let's give a value to the text. Value equal to, this is value. Okay, observe this. I'll be asking this question. Right? Value equal to, this is value. Okay, now here by the side of radio, I'll say this is the text. Okay, and this is the checkbox text. Observe this. I'm not writing this inside the tag, I'm writing this outside the tag. Okay, so here I'll just give a value here. So every time, remember, the value should be what do you call it? It's a reference to the text which is written outside the radio tag. For instance, if you write mail here, okay, the value should be a reference. Like, how do you recognize mail? Let's say M stands for mail, right? Most of the times. Now let me give another input, radio button here, input type equal to radio again, right? Name equal to, and what is that, ID. ID equal to, no check for this, let's say value equal to F. So what is F reference to? F reference to female. So this is your choice, and do not worry about these values now, the radio box or checkbox values. Okay, so again, this value for checkbox must be in reference with the outside, let's say checked, or let's say okay, accept. let's say I say no, instead of this I'll use I am accepting the terms and condition. I am accepting the terms and conditions. Okay, let's come back here and let's type here. Now you see there's a difference between placeholder and value, if you can observe that. So the placeholder is just an informational text, but for value I can edit the value here. You see that I cannot edit the placeholder, but I can still edit the value here. And coming to the password here, okay, so placeholder is visible in password field, whereas whenever I type something here, is it visible? Is it visible over there? The password is not visible over there, it's hidden. Okay, so I'm going to extend the time here. Let's extend. Oh, Sandeep is gone. So I'll extend to another 15 minutes and we'll be done. Forms is a huge class. Okay, so the difference between value and placeholder, remember placeholder is informational text, whereas value is nothing but the value of the form input. Okay, so here I type Sagar and this is the value there, whereas that's a placeholder. So remember the difference between placeholder and value. Placeholders are used for information and value is nothing but the value of the form. Now you see here, okay, now the text has come for the radio buttons too. This text is nothing but the text by the side of it. So to make radio button more meaningful, you are supposed to write a text beside it. And the one more thing here, you see this, these two are checked now, right? But I want to make only one out of those two checked. How is it possible? I want to make only one input radio type should be selected, not both of them at the time. So for that purpose I need a name here. So that is the name of that radio button should be gender, right? It's a gender, male and female. So gender given something like that, a gender. And here a refresh. Okay, again the value can be edited, placeholder cannot be edited. And now you see male, see that only one of those two can be selected. Right, only one of these two can be selected. So radio button's purpose is that only out of many only one should be selected. Like for instance your, let's say the gender can be only one, nobody can have the two genders. Or let's say present or absent, anybody can be present or absent at the same time, they cannot be both present and absent at the same time, right? So radio boxes or radio buttons are used only when there is a feasibility that one should be selected only. Okay, and remember to that happen you should have name of the two radio buttons the same. So the name should be same for both the radio buttons. If the name is not same, let's say I just make this Jenner, okay, something else, I see this and I click on female, it still gets selected, and male also is getting selected there. Okay, I don't want that to happen. So to avoid that, the name should be same. Okay, remember this, the name should be same. If they belong to the same category, same, the name should be same. Alright, so these are the buttons and stuff. So this is the basic form there. Okay, this is how you design a form. Okay, and there are some things here. So now I want to disable this type equal to button thing. So for that there is an option called disable. Oh. Alright, so I said disable for the type equal to button. Now I come here, I can't click it. You see that? I can't click it. It is disabled. Okay? And I want to make this text box read only, let's say. Okay, so what I do is, okay, instead of this value, I say this is read only. I'll say this is read only. So the attribute to be used is read only. let's see. So I come here. So now see, I cannot type in anything. It's just read only. Okay, this is disabled. This is read only. Okay. And password, you can see it here, password is hidden. If you use only password field, the password is hidden. Okay, that's the beauty of the password. So every time if you want to type, if you want to let your users to type passwords, use the type equal to password, and there's the checkbox over there. And then the next is size. You can see the size of this password. Let's just increase the size of the password. The default is 20. Okay, the default is 20. I'm gonna give 40 here. Oops, this is the size. You see it? It has been doubled now. So you can control the size. But what I do is max length. Okay, max length equal to, I'll give just 2 there. Okay, I've given max length equal to 2. Let's see here. Come to password. See? I'm typing it here, but it's not letting me type. It's only taking 2 characters because the max length is 2. Okay, I'll be posting questions again in tomorrow's class about this class. So go through it thoroughly. The videos, they will appear tomorrow. Okay, so max length is used. So what's the difference between size and max length? Size will define the length of the text box, whereas max length will decide the number of characters it can take. So now here I'm typing it. I'm typing it, but I cannot really go forward than more than 2 letters. That's the max length over there. And we have one more attribute called, I'm gonna use one more input box here. Input this time, okay, let's use email. This is curious. This is nice. Email ID equal to this. Placeholder. I'll use a placeholder. Placeholder equal to enter valid email, I'll say. Okay, placeholder, or let's say placeholder is just email. Enter email, enter email. And autofocus. Okay, let me just remove autofocus. So let's see what really happens over there. I want to see what really happens there. So let me use a BR so it appears in proper shape. So refresh. This is the email, right? Okay, I'll say A. Oh, actually, when I say submit only, it will say, when I try to submit, you see, please include an @ in the email address, is missing an @. So this will validate the information too. This just does not take information, it validates too. Okay, so let me refresh this. You see that nothing's happening here, right? But I'll say on the email item, I'll say autofocus. I'll ask this question to you guys now. You have to tell me what does autofocus do. So now I'm gonna refresh it. Check the difference. Okay, I'm just zooming it. Okay, to show you guys the difference. So now tell me what's the difference. What happened here? On the email, I have made autofocus. What's really happening there? Okay, so for that, again, the difference, I'm gonna delete this autofocus. I will refresh. Okay, I'm typing here, nothing is happening. I'm literally typing here, nothing's happening. So I'm gonna put autofocus again. I'll save it. I'll refresh this and I'll start typing. Now you guys tell me what's the difference. So autofocus will go to that text box directly and I can directly start typing in. Okay, this is useful in registration forms, you know, when user comes here and clicks, instead of that, you can, okay, this is read only. You can directly just put in, prompt him to do that. Okay, that's there. And okay, and there is one more attribute called required. Okay, so I'll say the password is required. So let's see what happens when I ask for required. So I refresh this. Email is autofocus. Okay, password is required. So I'm gonna just remove that value. Okay, I have removed that value. I'll try to submit there. It says please fill out this field. Okay, so require is used to make something mandatory to fill. So it's required. Okay, so oh, there's a spelling mistake here. No problem. Alright, so this is about the forms, and we have type equal to URL, and let's see about date. This is seriously awesome. I mean, this is HTML5 feature here. So input type equal to date, name equal to something, we don't really need name for the date, ID equal to blank again. Okay, no placeholder, or maybe we can use a placeholder, maybe placeholder equal to enter a date, let's say. Okay, so I'll refresh. Okay, the placeholder did not work there. Okay, I'm gonna refresh. You see, this is the date. Now you see that a default drop-down has come up and a calendar has come up for date. Okay, so that is today's date. I can close it, I can do it, I can select another date. So I can, you know, go back. So here I can go to the this, I can go to the I can go back to the years, maybe here 2013, so Jan, go back 2012, June 20. Can, you know, this is the cool feature of HTML5, wherein you can pump in the date directly, you don't need any plugin there. Okay, so that is it, guys. So that's about today's class, the basic form elements and the advanced form elements, like, you know, date. Okay, date and URL. We did not see the URL, but fine. You try it out. Okay, I'll be giving a notes on this most probably by tomorrow. Okay, and don't miss the video. This is really important, forms, and I don't have time to show that in the, you know, portfolio. But I'll be giving an assignment on that. You know, how to put that in your portfolio page? How to put a form? I'll ask you guys the important fields over there. Okay, so that's about that. So I'm gonna share my close my screen share here. So now guys, tell me any questions here. Any questions here regarding the HTML forms? So first of all, that's quite heavy. There are, right, how to remember, like, can you give me an example, like remember, suppose I type Sagar, let's say, do you mean to say how to remember Sagar? Or do you mean to say what type to be used when? Oh, that's a checkbox. That's a checkbox. So that's a fancy checkbox. So that's a checkbox. So the syntax for that will be something like this. So you do this, input type equal to checkbox. Okay, so the name equal to, I'll say name equal to remember me. Okay, name equal to remember me, and the value equal to R, let's say. Okay, and I close it and I'll say remember me. That's it. So that's a checkbox. But how do you process is in PHP. Okay, that's using PHP. Yeah, no problem.